Going to walk through how to restore your Apple TV. A couple days ago, I turned on my Apple TV and I saw this nice picture of an Apple TV connecting to iTunes, and the box was just blinking like crazy. So what you need to do is connect it to iTunes. How you do that? On the back, right underneath the HDMI port, is a USB port. It's actually a micro USB, and the cable does not come with Apple TV. You'll see you can use any cell phone micro USB. I found my BlackBerry had one, so it's not mini USB, it's micro on one end and then your standard USB. So I'm just going to plug the micro USB right into my Apple TV, and then I'm going to plug the other part into my PC or MacBook. So definitely don't bother to spend any money on that. You likely will have one, or you could pick one up for about $7. Okay, so when you plug it in and you open up iTunes, it should recognize it. You see on the left under Devices, Apple TV. If it doesn't, this is not going to work. And I actually had trouble with my PC. I don't know why, but running Windows 7, it never recognized it. So I have a MacBook. I use that. And then in the center, there's a button that says Restore Apple TV. So just click that, and it starts downloading all kind of drivers and things or whatever. So that takes a really long time. And the other thing I ran into is that this would download. It would take like 20 minutes, a half hour. You see, you can clip on iTunes up on the top right there. You can see how far. And it looks like it was completely downloaded. And I would wait and wait forever. And then eventually I would get this message. I think it's going to show up soon. It says, basically, you know, you have a problem, it didn't work. Now, the thing I found out is I was trying to do this over Wi-Fi, and I don't know why, but when I plugged it directly into my router, I finally got the nice message here. So that was the only tips I really have, is that I could not get this to work on Windows. I had to use a MacBook for iTunes to recognize it, and then the downloading, I could not do it over Wi-Fi. It doesn't really make any sense, but that's what happened. So just in summary, I used a mini USB cable from an old cell phone connected to the MacBook. iTunes recognized it, and then I connected my MacBook directly to my router on one of the four ports with a Cat5 cable and disabled Wi-Fi, and that seemed to take care of it. And once it downloaded and it said it was completed, I just basically connected back up to my TV, and I was good to go.